see our setup for this particular video. We've got a camera here that I'm looking at. Hello, nice to see you. Miss Jessica has a camera there that Hello. She's looking at. Plus, we have this high camera so that you can see her arm a little close up as we do this. This is a thing, guys. We worked hard to put this together for you so that you could see a little better. And today we're doing zombie makeup tutorial. This was something we'd done for a while. We used to do a Halloween program called GPL Spooktacular, and then we joined with the Parks Department. It became Monster Mash, and at both of those programs, we did these events where we would do monster makeup and zombie wounds and flesh stuff. I don't know what that meant. We're good, though. It's fine. So we're going to do a quick tutorial on that, and I hadn't done it in a while, so I did get to sit in the teen room yesterday and zombify my hand. So Miss Jessica, we have her kind of set up. This is what we're going to start with, but I'll show you how we got to here. I wanted it to be dry, though, before we started, and because we are being as safe as we possibly can, because there is no way I can zombify her and socially distance. We have a screen up, this here. You can kind of see it is a screen, so there is a shield between us, and we are going to be leaving our masks on. So we're trying to be as safe as possible. But I'm going to have her put her other hand in for a moment. And so we are going to create a wound on her hand. Now, you can use liquid latex. I just prefer not to. I think this other method is a lot more fun, and I think you can just have equally as much fun with it. And for this, you need toilet paper. And I will say that if you get a toilet paper, this is single ply. If you get a toilet paper that has a very distinct embossed design, you will see that in your zombie wound. Not that that's not fun and cool too. I mean, that's a good time as well. But this is dollar store cheap, dollar store toilet paper. It's fairly smooth. There's some flowers or two in there, but you don't see it as much. And then just plain old Elmer's glue. So we're going to start out here, and we're just going to put some glue all over Miss Jessica.
It tickles.
It does tickle. Is it cold?
It's a little cold.
All right. So then we're going to take the toilet paper, and we're going to take off a few squares. And I'm going to start with just putting it on here to move the glue around a little bit and to create our kind of our base. As we go through this, you're going to learn that I know nothing about costume stuff or makeup in general or how to do this. But I have fun with it, and I think you can have fun with it too. I know we have had some teens that have come to our Zombie Fest program. Who go all out and are very good at this kind of thing. And I have watched many a YouTube video where I'm like, it's terrifying how good these people are at makeup. This is not one of those. You know, this is for the person that doesn't know what they're doing and just wants to have a good time trying something new, or misses us and just wants to say hi. So, hi.
Hi.
We miss you too. So we have our first layer, and we're just gonna put this on here. If you're watching and you can't hear us, please let us know, and we will try to work on that technology. Miss Jessica is watching us as we do this, because, again, we're nothing if not professionals, so it's a good time.
I have us right here, just in case somebody decides to send us a message. Feel free.
Feel free.
I will attempt to write back with my wounded hand, my wounded arm, not my wounded hand.
With the power of your imagination.
Yes.
So, Miss Jessica, are you a zombie person?
I'm not a huge zombie person. I prefer funny zombie.
Okay. I do too. I mean, if I have to choose, I prefer funny.
Yeah, I am a big
zombie fan. The older zombie movies, the black and white ones, Night of the Living Dead and that, they're okay. Shaun of the Dead, the romantic comedy set during a zombie apocalypse is more my speed. Or there was one called Fido, where they would start to make zombies into pets. I did enjoy that one as well.
Warm Bodies.
Warm Bodies really is fantastic. And that one's based on a book. So yeah, if you do love zombies.
Book.
Yes. Have you created, so now we've created it. I know it doesn't look like much. It looks like I just glued some toilet paper to Miss Jessica's hand. And that's basically what I did. So once you kind of have created the shape of your wound, you let that dry. And now we're going to switch. I wanted you to kind of see what was happening. So let's bring this back. And whoa, movie magic, guys.
Ta-da! Look at that.
It's like the cooking shows where they pull a perfectly cooked thing out of the oven.
This is because we did this about an hour and a half to 2 hours ago.
It does not take that long to dry.
No.
But we just did not have a lot of time because there were other things that needed to do. So we thought we'll do it ahead of time. So I, on this one, put an extra layer, like I rolled some up and put them on the side here because I wanted my wound to look deep. So once it starts to dry, you start to kind of cut and peel away so that you have an opening as if you've been gashed. Is that it? You've been sliced. You've been cut,
attacked,
bit.
Oh yes.
You know, whatever happened. Okay, your zombie thing. Have you created a plan for a zombie?
Oh,
apocalypse?
A zombie apocalypse. Yes, I have.
That's not what I want.
We had a book club a while back where we read the book Ashfall by Mike Mullen. And decided then that we should probably create some sort of apocalypse plan.
Because one could happen. We might be living in a sort of one right now.
We might. I think maybe we are. But on that day, we kind of made a little bit of a plan. And I think the first thing was that we need to go to Camping World because it's very nearby start gathering supplies. And we have a connection there. One of our volunteers works there, and she was very helpful in letting us know what we should get and what we shouldn't, and we might just go there and start rummaging. And then we are going to go to Miss Valerie's house, if I remember correctly, because she has a built-in bunker.
She does have a bunker. It's fascinating.
Yes. So we're going to go there to wait it out. And
I
always
thought somewhere like Sam's Club or Costco because they don't have windows. So it's not like you would have to protect a lot of places for them to get in.
This is
true.
They
got lots of food. So I like this. Mm-hmm. I guess I should explain the next step now. So the first thing we're going to do is create a flesh-colored base coat on her wound. That way you don't see the white toilet paper. I would not buy nice makeup for this. Go to the dollar store and buy some makeup. You can get the whole kits that let you do monster makeup, which is fine. I don't know if I should show the kind of, I don't know what copyright thing. You can buy kits like this. You don't need to, though. You can use what you have at home, or you can just use really cheap stuff. I would recommend getting some makeup sponge witches.
Different people call them different things. So
I have also picked up a palette of purples and blues eyeshadow. And then some of these sponge brushes, is that what they are? I don't know what they are.
Oh.
We will also be using, this is more of a cream eye makeup. I would love to see someone put some of these actually on. I think that would be fascinating. This is some cream makeup, a monster makeup. We are going to be using a brown, a black, and a silver or gray. And then of course you need blood because every wound oozes. So that's what we'll be using today. So I'm going to work on the base coat while Miss Jessica continues about the bunker.
Yeah.
What do you think? What is an important thing that you think you need to put in the bunker? I mean, books.
Books.
You need to entertain
yourself. Water. Water. I feel like having some sort of fresh water in a or water bottles might be a good idea because I don't know that after whatever this apocalypse is, that we would have fresh water coming out of a water faucet.
I also thought about grabbing, if you're at Camping World, you could just grab a camper and then just drive as far away from humans as you absolutely need to. There was one apocalypse book, I think it might have actually been zombies too, that I read that they, when it happened, when it went down, they were out in the wilderness, but then they didn't have enough supplies, so they had to go out back into humanity to get stuff, and then they realized everybody was starting cults. It was creepy. I think I would just try to get as far away from people as I possibly could.
I enjoy watching some of those doomsday bunker people who are creating their own I find that fascinating, a little crazy maybe, but fascinating, those preppers.
Hey, they're going to be ready.
And I do. I agree that they're going to be ready. There was a guy on TV the other day that I saw that he bought this. I mean, he spent, like, everything he had, and he bought this giant, it's like a train car almost, like a big giant train car, and then he dug a hole in the ground and buried the car so that they could live inside of it when the apocalypse happens, underground. And then they had like they had an area for sanitation.
Makes sense. You need to have that away from you.
Yes. Yeah. And then they had a different place where they buried their food. And then they also had, throughout their entire property, which they had a lot of property, they had food randomly buried.
Smart.
Throughout as well.
So this was just a liquid makeup foundation. Not too bad. A little darker than Miss Jessica's skin.
Miss Jessica's skin is very pale, and so it is... You have to buy, like, the lightest makeup, too.
Now we're going to do silver, because we want to make it to start look like it's decaying. I'm using the same sponge. That's fine, guys. Just do you. And we're just going to pat that in here. We have people watching us from the window, which is fun.
Hello.
Please do feel free to comment if you're watching.
Yeah, absolutely. We would love to chat. There's someone watching. I don't know who that someone is.
Oh.
But someone is. Hello, someone. I also found that, I used to do monster makeup in school, where we would do old age makeup, because I took a drama class.
The drama club.
Yeah.
Classes.
Yeah, it wasn't really a full club. But we had a couple classes where we would work on some different makeup, and I had a kit forever, and it was basically this exact same stuff. Had some latex in it you could use to, like, make a wart on your nose, or, you know, if you needed elf ears, they work for that. But really, we didn't use latex a whole lot. We mostly just drew everything on.
I'm also green, I'm sorry.
Yes.
Because you're really starting to... Okay, now I'm going to use the darker brown. I did read, it hasn't been too long, that I read Dry by Neil Schusterman. That was very good. It was an apocalyptic thing. And guys, I'm just dabbing. I'm creating. This is good for color mixing. So if you like to see what colors look like when you mix them together, this is also great.
I also find that if you do have a little bit of white that ends up showing through at the end, can always just explain it as bone
or maggots.
Yeah, good stuff. It's a festering wound.
They're not going to let us do lives together. Okay,
probably shouldn't.
Oh, the camera, it's starting to look good, guys. Oh, I don't know about you, but she's starting to look really gross. All right, so now I'm going to, because I want to cover it up with the darker, we're going to add just a touch of green. Just a touch. Just a dab, dab, dab.
And to really show some of that mold and grossness.
Gangrene.
Decay. Lovely. I don't know why I like
gross things.
They did
not do all of this in the zombie movie I was in.
They didn't?
No, I did get blood. I mean, there was some makeup. I didn't get any wounds. Some people got wounds. I wasn't that lucky. In fact, the first time I went, I think they really just kind of put white on my face and then covered me in blood, which was just corn syrup and food dye. And it was a nightmare because it was sticky.
It doesn't.
So your clothes then stuck to you, and when you tried to get off, you were just tearing out your body hair. It was an unfortunate time. Usually. But we had so much fun that we went back again. When they called us back, we're like, yeah, I'll be there. It was me and my father. You know, good family bonding time.
Did the corn syrup blood smell weird?
It didn't. But I did have a good time because I went to Mrs. Kerbel's.
Oh.
And they almost didn't serve me.
Because you looked like a zombie.
But, you know, I'm running out of green.
They were worried and actually wanted to call the police?
Yeah, probably. Not the first time. People have worried about me and my sanity. Okay. All right. So we're starting to really get kind of gross here. You don't want to overdo it with the green. But you know how the different stages of bruising, if you bruise as often as I bruise, You get to see all the different colors.
Especially if you look kind of, I don't know if you can, there we go, yeah. You can see really how it's starting to.
So now we're going to add just a touch of black for some super rot. My glass is starting to fog up, so this could get interesting here. And this is going to help with the bruising look.
And help fill in some of those empty spots.
Which is just hard, because the toilet paper wants to come with you, but that's fine. Yeah. And you do just want to keep dabbing so it doesn't look like you just have a, look, I just, there's some, I would blend more if they have a, but it's fine.
Well, and the nice thing is that it comes off pretty easily when you're done.
Except for the blood.
Well.
That stays.
It stains a little, but it'll come off in a couple days.
You can't see my blood today.
Yeah.
All right, so we've got the basics.
Ooh.
She's starting to look pretty gross. Now we're going to add just some touch of purples. Does somebody on?
Yeah, someone said hi.
Oh, hello, friend. And I'm going to take one of my sponge brushy thingies, and I'm going to just get, I'm going to get a bit of this, purple-y. Brighter purple. Now, you might want to make sure that you don't get something with glitter. That doesn't really go well with bruising.
No.
But I'm just going to start.
Unless the zombie went to a rave.
That would be awesome.
We should have a zombie rave.
We should. They had zombie raves in, like, iZombie, the TV show.
I love that show so much.
She would eat brains and temporarily have the memories of the person's brain she was eating.
My favorite part is her cooking the brains because she likes to try different recipes. She always adds hot sauce because that's really all they can taste. They need hot sauce to make sure things taste good. But yeah, the best part is her like turning it into tacos or waffles. Like she does some really weird things with brains.
Okay.
I'm endorsing cannibalism or
that's
something.
Okay. A little bit starting a little bit of red. Mm-hmm. So it looks like some dried blood here.
It does. It looks pretty good. I forgot I was gonna talk about this book box thing over here.
We'll wait till your arm's done.
Yeah.
That way you can
talk about it now.
I don't know. I think it looks a lot cooler in the video than it does
in real life.
In real life.
Wonder what that is. Huh. Movie magic.
I know. So we're just looking like we're much better at this than we actually are. I'm going to do a little bit of brown here, try to cover up some of these spots. It's all really going to come together here in just a moment.
It will. As soon as you add that blood.
So again, you can do these here. We'll use a little bit of this red here. And you're just, I'm going to put a little on my finger and just kind of start on the edges like some blood. You can't really see it, but some blood stain her just a little bit.
That's okay. Yeah. It doesn't itch at all now. No. It itched a little bit earlier when the glue was drying, but not so much now.
Put these together.
Oh yeah, that's the best part.
Sorry. I digress. All right, so then we're using vampire blood, which I assume is much like zombie blood. I don't know the difference.
They're all monsters.
Now, this is oozy, so just be aware of that. If your mother has nice linens, don't do it over that, or don't use a good wash rag. Or
try not to wear your best dress.
Dress cloth, yeah. So we're just going to go there, and we're going to let it dry just a little bit.
What is that?
I don't know. Guys, I'm loving it.
This
I'm
might be
it.
One of the best that we've ever done. You've ever done. I'm not actually doing anything other than sitting here and turning into a zombie.
All right. So what do you think, guys? See, that's not hard. It took, about 20 minutes? And we could have done it faster, but we were talking to you, too, because we miss your faces. And we wish we could have shown you ours, but... All right, so while that is drying, I'll hold the box and you can discuss
what's in it. Oh, I can just talk about it.
That
sounds like fun.
That way you don't have to drip blood on it, which would be good. Hold on, I'm going to just toss everything in my box here.
If you want to know what this looks like right now,
It's starting to get hard.
It's starting to harden up.
See? And you really do need it to. So this is the point then, still when it's a little tactile, that you will start to tear.
You want
to. And then you
that.
Can start to kind of form a little bit.
Make that hole right in the middle yeah. to.
For your gash.
For your gash. Oh, there's blood down my hands.
Yeah, I have it on my hands. All right. Okay, here we go. I'm going to move this out of the way.
All right.
So, Miss Jessica, what is your next favorite book box?
Your next favorite book box is a subscription box where you can register on the website. We do 5 per age group
weeks,
per
yeah.
month. Yeah. So you
ten
get
per month,
10 per month.
5 every 2 weeks.
Mm-hmm. So teens can sign up and you get to fill out a quiz. You'll get a quiz sent from me after you sign up. And it just kind of gets an idea about what you like, what you don't like, so that we can pick a book for you. And then that's what we do. We choose you a book. Inside, you will get a letter that says, "Hey, awesome readers." And then it gives you an explanation of what's in the box and what comes next. Then you will see that there is a "What do you think?" card for you to fill out for a review and a chance to win a $25 gift card if you turn that back in. A list of recommendations, other books that you might like if you like the book that we picked for you. Of course, you will get the book. A book that belongs to the library that will be checked out under your name when you come in. And then you get to take it home and read it and bring it back when you're done and let us know what you think. You'll also get some swag. So I like to make my swag. And with the book, you will find usually the swag is either relating to the book specifically that I gave you, or it will be something else that you enjoy. Maybe you told me, like in this case, that you like The Mandalorian. So if you get a This Is The Way bookmark, you're gonna get some candies. You're gonna get some buttons. And, oh, there you go. That is actually the main character from the book.
Oh, that's
so
fun.
Yeah, so there's just a lot of random stuff that you'll get along with it.
And you
as
get
well
to keep
as,
all the swag.
Yeah, yeah, you get to keep all the swag and you get to read a book, have a recommendation just for you. And if you like it, you can do it again.
So in order to find this, you go to our website at greenwoodlibrary.us and under Programs and Services, you're going to see our events calendar where it says Programs and Registration. And then you're going to look for your next favorite book box, the TeenHQ edition, and you will sign up there, and then Miss Jessica will send you the information like that quiz to get you started. So it's a lot of fun. If you're in a reading rut and you're not quite sure what to read next, it's a great way to have a recommendation. If you've already signed up, you're welcome to sign up again for the next month. We do just want to let you know that if we have 5 new people sign up, we might put you on the waiting list just so we can get as many teens participating as we possibly can. You do not have to sign up for this program in order to get book recommendations from Jessica. So you can always just come into the room and we'll be happy to help you find your next favorite read. And that's our goal. We'll keep trying until we find it. We do have some teens. Oh, you're starting to get drippy. We do have some teens that it's getting harder and harder to find books because they've read so many of the ones that are in the room, which we just absolutely love. And so one day we'll be able to then transition them upstairs so that we can continue to find them great books. So
yeah.
Also going on, we have Superhuman Samurai Cyber Squad. So you can sign up for that through December, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And that is a self-guided tech program that we are able to put on because of a grant from Best Buy where you complete four different modules and each module has 5 different activities that go along with it. And then if you complete all of the activities, you get a swag bag from us with some cool tech like a fisheye lens thing for your phone, your smartphone. A Bluetooth speaker, some candy,
power bank,
and then you also get entered into a raffle for an Oculus Go virtual reality. I was like virtual something headset.
VR headset.
So we are going to be giving one of those away as well. So make sure you look on our website. All of the information on that program is on there as well. We are also about to start some in-person programming in very small groups. So if you are a D&D player, be checking the website for that. We've got our D&D campaigns that are going to happen at the library starting in November. We have gaming tournaments or video games will be back on Tuesdays.
Tuesdays starting November the 10th, I believe is the first one. Yep.
Yep.
Because we're closed on the 3rd.
Movie, you're going to start showing movies on Fridays?
I'm going to play some movies on Fridays throughout November and December.
Those just are chill
cause.
Things. Yeah. Or if you are at home and you were doing e-learning and you're mm-hmm. just tired of being at home, feel free to come to the library to use the space for that.
Yeah.
So there's more happening in November. Make sure to check out that events calendar. There's a lot going on.
Don't forget, we do still have our TeenHQ Discord going, and we still have lots of teens on there discussing Absolutely. Lots of crazy stuff, like their favorite animals or places they want to travel or... some weird, they write back and forth, or you can get to read each other's writing, poetry. Somebody just posted a bunch of nature pictures that they took out on a vacation. It was really cool. So yeah, definitely check out our Discord as well.
All right. Well, I think we were successful here today, guys. Yeah. Miss Jessica looks disgusting.
Mostly. Most of the time.
We had a little fun chatting about books and apocalypses and got to share some stuff with you. Come say hi to us in TeenHQ. We would love to see your faces. And we will be back next month with more TeenHQ videos. See you later.
Bye.
Bye.